What's going on, everybody?
Hey, y'all.
We are back. Woo! It's Drinks and Conversation,
the podcast.
We are episode 30. Yeah, 30.
I thought I was 29.
We're 30.
We grown out here.
We done passed.
Okay.
We adults now.
We 30, flirty, and thriving.
We getting all a right. Problem. It's Intro Picks, and I'm always in the building.
And I'm oxytocin, and it's always going down.
Yes, indeedy. What up, Toes?
Ain't nothing much. What's going on with you, Scratch?
I am waiting for the weekend.
You and me both.
I can't wait.
What do you have planned for the weekend?
Well, I heard Shantae Moore is in town.
Oh, I thought she had a man at home.
Nah.
She left though.
She left me, I mean to say. She's in town.
Okay, she's doing a show, I'm
she's
sure,
She's doing
right?
a show.
You going? With,
I'm thinking about it.
Okay.
Team Familiar. Familiar Faces and Shantae Moore.
Oh, yeah. That's dope.
So that's going to be
dope. That's going to be hot.
Yeah. So I got the invitation about a couple days ago.
Okay.
And, Shantae Moore, welcome to D.C.
DMV.
Yeah. So why not? What about you? What do you got planned for the weekend?
You know how I live my life. I really don't know. I don't think I have any plans this weekend. Somebody hit me up about going to a 90s party, and I was like, what do you wear to a 90s party?
I mean,
and don't say gaucho.
No.
Okay.
I forgot about a gaucho. That's so some shirts were stupid. No, to a 90s party, basically,
hey,
you know. Nah, that's like 80s. Like, you want something, like some jeans, some over, maybe like a FUBU jacket, maybe. I don't know.
70s, I got it. 80s, I'm down.
But 90s, it's like 90s. Cool. It's just cool.
I don't know about the 90s.
It's just cool. Or you could do it. At 90s was everything baggy.
I'm going to thug it out.
Yeah. TLC.
Call the cops if you see Aaliyah.
You know.
That little Tupac verse, you know. Maybe not. I don't know. Okay. Moving on.
Did you go and see Finding Dory?
No, I didn't. A little part of me wanted to see it, but I was like, I'm not about to spend that type of money for this movie. So no, but I will see it eventually.
Finding Dory was a good movie. Actually, I went to go and see it. And it was a good movie, but it's something that you should probably wait to see. It wasn't like a Finding Nemo.
How much was your movie ticket?
I had passes. So
okay.
I didn't even, you know what I'm saying?
No,
got
little
a little connect.
Steak.
Got a little
cheesecake.
Really?
You make her think you're slide in the ticket.
Slide in the. She's like, you got the tickets already? Yep,
yeah.
Got the tickets
you
already.
You go get the popcorn. I'm going to pay for these tickets because I got vouchers. No.
You know what? You know, after going to a movie theater, if you ever been to one of the movie theaters with the reclining chairs.
Every time.
Yeah,
every,
that's the only way to movie theater.
Look, I'm not bougie, but you know what? People typically start off saying they're not something they are.
Really,
let me take that
really
back.
Are.
I enjoy going to the theaters with the reclining seats, and that's the only theater I ever go to.
Yeah.
I can't do the little bus, the little Greyhound seats. I can't do those anymore.
You can recline and sit back and just
kick
you know,
your
enjoy.
Feet all the way up the lazy boy action. I love it.
It works. Well, you got people in Congress that's taking seats, but they ain't got no lazy boy. They ain't got no. they just right on the House floor.
The new age sitting
protesting. I guess.
I mean, but I think if they're gonna protest anything, the gun laws are worth it. I guess. If I'm going to say, you know.
I don't see what the big deal is as far as you shouldn't be able to get assault rifles. I mean, you shouldn't be able to get automatics. You shouldn't be able to get these things.
I don't even know what you'd be needing that for. And just like regular folk, what do you need that for? Or you need to walk into a gun system. Let me get that semi-automatic.
Let me get that.
Let me get that Uzi, right? Like, no. Like,
and I understand people are gun collectors. And I understand, like, you know. It goes back, you know, in our history and whatnot, well, in the history of America. And I also just feel like just come on, like this is common sense. Can it's we get common sense stuff together?
You already know common sense is what? Not common.
Nope, not with politics.
That's not going to
don't
happen.
Work. It don't work. It don't work. But I'm glad they doing like a little filibuster. I'm glad that we're seeing something. I don't know if it's gonna work, you know. But
at least they're making moves.
They need to
get
it together. And to think they're literally right in our backyard.
Let me go look at the winds right now. I understand. No, I get you. I get you.
Yeah. So.
I hope they work something out, because if one thing I know is that we need to get these guns off the street that are already on the streets, and they shouldn't be so readily available. Like, it shouldn't be so easy to get one. That's it. There needs to be a better vetting process before people are just able to walk in and purchase these guns. That's all I'm saying.
Now, have you gotten caught up on your politics and who you vote for? Election season is coming up, so.
I know. I'm working on it.
Have you did your research?
Yes. I have.
You have. So yes. who are we voting for?
I haven't decided yet. I have not decided yet.
You only got Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton.
No, Bernie didn't drop out yet.
I mean, Bernie did make an announcement that, you know, he's not going to be the Democratic nominee.
Oh, when?
Just literally, like yesterday.
Oh, I see. You know, I have a 72-hour layover when I watch the news. So in 3 more days, I'm going to catch back.
So when the world ends, you're going to be a little late. It was on TV.
Just a little bit. Just a little bit.
So, yeah, he said, he knows that he's not going to be the Democratic nominee. I want him to, and I want him to go all the way, but it's not working that way.
So you're a Democrat.
Yeah, I'm really an independent. I'm at whatever base.
So are you assuming that I'm a Democrat?
I don't know which you are.
Okay, I know, because you're just telling me, am I going to vote for Hillary? But you.
I say it's either between Hillary or Donald Trump. That's all you have to choose.
Well, I don't know yet.
You know it's going to be Hillary.
You ain't tell no
lie. I don't know yet.
You ain't tell no lie.
Ain't none of my friends voting for Donald, okay?
How you? What if I want to vote for the Donald?
And then we can't be friends. That's how serious it is.
So then bye-bye, podcast.
That's how serious. If you voting for the Donald, we can.
Well, guess what? I want to say today that I am...
You ain't voting for nobody.
All right, talking about Donald Trump really gives me a headache. But we can move on from Donald Trump.
We can move on from Donald.
Donald was Gooch. That's all he gets for me.
That's all he gets. So Gladys Knight. Go ahead.
Gladys Knight. I remember her. He's leaving.
Leaving.
On that midnight train to Georgia.
Yeah. Well, what's going on that midnight train to Georgia is Gladys Knight's chicken and waffles, because they're not coming back. They done got raided.
I know. They got raided. About that for, tax evasion or... But my big thing is, should she be held responsible for that? If my name is on it and I'm the public figure and I'm known, but you're actually running the day-to-day business, I feel like whoever's running it should be held liable. Not me, because my name is on the marquee.
Yeah, no, it should be you. Because of the simple fact of, if you bought a house, right, it's your house, but if somebody else sets it on fire, who's responsible?
I don't even know about that analogy.
Who got to deal with all that?
But the same thing with Mike Vick. I don't think he should have went to jail for those dogs. I don't think
he should have went to jail for those
dogs. No, he should not have.
Why?
Because I'm being nice. Now, if you just went on vacation or you went somewhere, I'm sorry, and you had, let's say you had a family member, or your sister is in your house.
Okay.
Should your sister, she's an adult, should she be held responsible for what goes on here while you are not around?
Yes.
Okay, he wasn't home.
No. You should be held.
You said yes.
No, and I'm about to take it back.
No, you can't take it back. Once it's out in the atmosphere, it's there. This is recorded, buddy. You cannot take it back.
We're going to chop it out. No. If somebody's in your house and they're responsible to a T, but overall, it's your responsibility. Who you let in, who you do. And like, It's your business.
I get
it doesn't
you.
Make a difference. If you're the owner, you're the sole responsible.
I get that. I but when you're it. Out
you're
of
you're solely
town.
Responsible
no,
for it.
It's not like it's a stranger or his homeboy. It was family. It's like that's your family.
So
and
what?
You're an adult. And you think you're leaving someone so, responsible
but
in
guess
charge.
Guess what? Now family that messed up your money. Okay.
He should not have went to jail. At the end of the day, I don't think one person should go to jail for what some other individual who was an adult did. I just don't think that's right. It's not fair. It's like Gladys Knight should not be held responsible to an extent. It should be her son because he was handling the day-to-day businesses.
And you should have been a good owner.
Look, it's a lot of... So if something happens at the Target down the street from your house, the... CEO of Target is supposed to go to jail?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Because guess who they're going to sue? They're going to sue you. Yes. No. Yes. If something happens and it's a big enough,
it's just crazy
especially
to me.
When it comes down to the police and especially when it comes
the
down to
policia?
Your brain. Yeah. When it does, you're responsible.
I hear you, but
you know
I
what?
Just don't agree with that at all. Let me tell you, I can't be held liable for what no other grown person do but my damn
If somebody
self.
Drives your car.
Okay.
And they get into an accident.
Okay.
Who you think has to pay for those
Their
damages?
Insurance, the insurance of the person who's driving. Now, you know, insurance laws are very state to state.
You can have a license and no car. And I'm driving your car.
No.
If
well,
I, drive
I wouldn't
your
let
car
somebody who
I
didn't
get,
have any insurance drive my car.
They're not on your insurance.
No. Do you know, like
my insurance... My insurance
know,
covers
every-
my car. It doesn't cover me driving your car.
It's going to have to.
No, it
but
doesn't.
No, the insurance laws are different from state to state. So you do have to take that into account. Some places, if you are driving someone else's car and you have insurance, your insurance will pay for the other person's car, not the owner of the insurance's car. You.
That's if you have insurance.
And that just and that's. Depending on what state you're in.
Okay,
so that
let's say I don't have insurance. Who should be responsible?
You,
the question.
You wouldn't be driving my car, so I wouldn't have that issue.
Well, who would be responsible? The question.
The person driving the damn vehicle. Number one, you knew you didn't have any insurance. Number two, you got into the accident.
I don't have a car. How about have insurance if I don't have a car?
You shouldn't have asked to drive my car, nor should you have agreed to drive it. Had I even... If I offered
no, you,
you my, no. If I offered you my car and you don't have insurance or a license, it's your responsibility. Say,
oh, now it
no.
goes back to who
oh,
offered
no.
it.
Oh, no. I can't do that. See, you will be accountable for your actions.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
And it's not my action. It's my
it
actions.
Is.
But
it's
ultimately,
your actions that
it's your car.
My car.
It's your property.
Did the
You're
car
the owner.
Drive itself?
Well, guess what?
Did the car drive itself?
Did the owner give me permission?
Did the car drive itself?
Did the owner
itself?
Give me? No, it didn't drive
okay.
itself.
Who crashed the car? Ooh, I need a name.
I crashed the car.
Okay, so you pay. You crash,
no.
you pay.
Yeah, you're going to have to sue me. But they're going to sue you first.
I'm getting my car.
Because you're the owner.
No.
You're the owner of the car.
No. I'm just saying, I don't agree with that. But it is what it is. But Gladys Knight, honey, your son should be going down and not
no
you.
No more chicken and waffles, Gladys.
Gosh.
You know Gladys ain't got... What else do Gladys got to fall back on?
Let me tell you, she's leaving.
Leaving?
Yeah.
Out of Georgia.
Out of Georgia, yes.
And shut that chicken and waffle down, okay?
You're stupid.
Dang, well, they still got Waffle House.
I'm still trying to go down. It's like, it's shut down completely.
I'm not sure. I think it's under investigation.
Hopefully they have we got to finish the food supply. You got 2 weeks to
come and get all this chicken.
This business is done. You
I don't think
be
nobody
wants
none of
like
that,
that
chicken.
You can't be wasting food like that.
No. She couldn't do it. She couldn't do it. Not like Patty. Put
no.
Patty on.
You know what? She needs
Open
to sue her
bakery.
Son. She needs to sue her son. Because that's probably going to be the only way she'll get out of this.
She's suing her son.
Talking
broke.
About suing, let's
broke.
Talk about the Emmys. They're trying to sue Whitney Houston's estate.
Oh, yeah.
Now, that's
I heard about
big.
That.
That. I know.
That
I know.
Is. You know
I
it
mean,
ain't nobody
think,
but Pat Houston. That ain't nobody but Pat Houston.
I know, but I think that if I win an award, it's my award. Now, if I die, I wonder if Whitney left her thing. Well, it's her estate, so it really doesn't matter. But, like, it was mine. I'm no longer living, so therefore it belongs to my estate to do with whatever they want to do. You can't give me a award and say it was a loan. It's not a loan.
I mean, they can say whatever, you know. But
it's not a loan. Literally, if you win, if we win the best podcast award in the DMV, whatever, so. I wish somebody would tell me, oh, your award was a loan. Excuse me? Like, that doesn't even make sense.
No, it's not the award is a loan. It's the actual statue, the actual
trophy.
That's
the award,
yeah,
dog.
Yeah, I mean, but still.
I mean, that's the award.
I mean, no, you could get the verbal award. You have
Well, we're talking about the Emmys and Whitney Houston, so clearly the award is the Emmy. But I guess it's prestigious, so I should use the name, whatever. But the award slash Emmy, Emmy slash award. You got me.
Well, I think if they're going to sell it, they're going to sell it. Period, point blank.
Yeah, but they're trying to stop them from selling it, and I think they're wrong. Would they want it back? I'm just trying to figure out how
this works.
No, they're
saying it shouldn't be sold.
It's not for them to determine.
But it shouldn't be sold. It's not. And they shouldn't be selling it anyway.
I mean,
for what? A little piece of change?
I mean, but all this stuff is material.
But the resale value on that?
You know what I'm saying? Like,
you
I mean, you can't take it with you. It's going to be here for someone to sell.
No, but what I think they do is it's a loan, so therefore when a person dies or passes on, they take that award and give it to another.
Oh, they just be, recycling. Well, they recycle these awards and take when
Money
you use
saving rich. That's what it is. Money saving rich. You got to learn some keys.
I can't. So all these Oscars and stuff and everything is just recycled.
It's
same award. They just take it back and give it out.
Yep. That's how the Emmys is trying to do it.
I
don't know
if that's how they really
they
do
must
it.
Be. Well, let me say that. But yeah, the Emmys be wildin'.
They wildin' for real, trying to tell people what they can do with their stuff.
But you know who else is wildin'?
Who?
The Baton Rouge Police Department for arresting a woman for spanking her kids.
When they needed it.
And they needed it. So, I believe they was teenagers, and they broke into
the
house.
13 and 10. But I know one was 13 and one was 10.
Yep. They broke into a neighbor's house or someone's house and stole a whole bunch of stuff.
Robin.
Lucky they didn't get shot and killed.
Exactly.
And their mother came home and whooped that ass. Now, you know I'm a firm believer of the good old ass
whooping. I know you are.
You know.
You're a firm believer of whooping your own kids and other people's kids. Don't even
yes,
matter.
Yes, I am.
But my thing is that I didn't get from the story, and I've read the article, and I've watched it. Were the police, did the children call the police? Who called the cops? How did the cops get involved? Came home from work, kids in the house. She started whipping them. Like, okay, where did the police come into play? Were they just riding around and getting it? Or, I mean, I'm just trying to figure out where the cops come from.
Yeah, I'm not really too sure on that either. Like, where did they come from? I mean, I don't know. Somebody called them. She probably don't know.
In her media interview, when she was like, you know, the camera was on her, she said, oh, I grabbed the belt and just started beating them. But in the article, it says she grabbed, what's that, the little cable switch cord?
Uh-huh.
So there's another thing. Okay, what was used
it
to beat
them?
The belt
switch.
Or the cord?
No, it probably was because you know what?
She grabbed the closest thing to her, and rightfully so.
Yep.
I probably think she didn't even know what she used
and they
to
weapon. Talking about
you
they
know how pissed I would be.
Yeah. They talking
you know
about they
mean?
Was bleeding and all types.
You working hard. You're and to get a call like that at work, not at work.
No.
Then you gotta come off your job because your kids out there, your 13-year-old, that's crazy.
In the words of my grandfather, I would tear that ass up.
Absolutely. But America came and cops and stuff came pick and choose because when that Baltimore mother was out there, they called it a whooping. But she was going, Layla Ali, she was boxing her son and punching him in the face. So, okay, so when can we hit our kids? When can we not hit our kids?
Because,
I mean, what is the difference?
Well, let me ask you. Now, if you had to have the risk of losing your child from disciplining them, would you still discipline your kids?
I'm going to beat that.
Even if you lose the risk of losing them.
I know in the bottom of my heart that I'm a great parent. You know, my best is working.
You don't
and
still
my
think
child would rather
kids?
Be with me than with foster care. Or they'll go to foster care and I bet you they'll be crying to come back home. But
just because you're crying to come back home don't mean there's nothing you could do about it.
there may be something they could do about it.
No, there's nothing. If it's court ordered, there's nothing you're going to be able to do about it.
I don't know.
They take your kids. They could cry all day.
People get their kids back. So I don't know how that works. Maybe there's a 30-day probationary period.
That's a 30-day probation.
I don't know.
She's fighting for her kids to come home.
Well, hopefully they do come home, because I don't think that she has 5 or 6 kids or something like that. So, and they took all her kids, and that's a lot.
I bet you they won't do
that. She did the right thing. I don't know who's not beating their kids. And if you, I don't know. These would be some excellent kids.
I bet you ain't going to do that shit again.
I have to pop my baby a time or two, but, you know, it's just sad. I mean, look what they were doing. Like, if her kids weren't doing what they were doing.
Breaking into somebody's house.
Robbing. Burglar. It ain't going to take all the bounty back to your house. They don't even know how to steal correctly and rob. You don't go back to your house and y'all live in the same neighborhood.
And then the dad is actually in prison as well.
I know.
That
the
makes
cycle.
It even worse.
It's a cycle.
Yeah. I would have beat that ass.
I would have too.
You know?
She did the right thing. And the whatever officer, but we don't know. I don't want to speak too soon. I don't know the whole story. Let me just go ahead and put that out there.
Wrong.
But with the information I was given, her kids should not have been taken away. The children needed to get their behind beat. And shout out to the lady who just heard her story and just, you know, felt compelled to go down there and bail her out. But she would have still been in jail.
She would have
still been there had that lady not heard her story and bailed her out. That's $1,000.
Yeah, and not everybody has
that. But for a stranger, for somebody you don't even know. You know what I mean? So.
Because it's ridiculous. Like, come on.
It's
like,
crazy. That really could be anybody.
Yeah. You should be able to beat your kids. It's your child. Beat them.
As long as you don't kill them. Like,
as long as you don't kill them. Now, you can get close. Okay? You can get a little close. But as long as you don't kill them. And then,
Absolutely. I definitely want to take time out to say, doing this podcast, it's definitely... We need a team. You know what I mean? We can't always do it by ourselves.
No, we can't.
Definitely want to give a shout out to Amanda Wild. She is the social media coordinator for Drinks and Conversations, the podcast. Amanda, say what's up. Hey, Amanda don't know what's going on.
I know,
on.
Amanda. We're going to need you to get on the mic.
Oh, gosh, Amanda. So we're going to reintroduce her. Amanda Wild, say what's up to the people.
What's up? Hey, guys. How you doing?
All right, so we have Amanda. She found the craziest story that actually took place here in the DMV. So we're going to give her a moment to let us know what's going on, Amanda. What's so crazy?
What's so crazy about this
story? This comes out of D.C. Okay. A man got an ankle monitor, and it was put on his prosthetic leg. So when he committed a crime, his prosthetic leg was at home.
So, we got a man out here committing murder, and we got some of a man because he had a prosthetic limb that had a GPS in it.
So, they didn't know, putting on his ankle monitor, that his leg was fake.
They knew. They put it on the wrong leg.
They're trying to figure out how they made that.
They put it on the wrong leg. That was a damn good prosthetic. So the prosthetic was at home, and he out there limping and committing murder.
He was just
switching
legs. He was really on the good foot.
You know what? Are both legs prosthetic, or is it just one?
Just one.
Okay. How did they make that mistake?
I don't know how they made that mistake. It must have been a real light-looking ankle that was right there.
It say how did they find out that it was him? I'm curious to know.
Well, it says that eventually they figured out that the prosthetic leg wasn't with him because he hung around for 2 hours before or after the murder.
Okay.
They were like, why are you here when your prosthetic leg...
So they must have physically caught him.
He's going to slip up because they're going to be like...
I got you in my eyesight, but you...
I mean, so what? Did he have a spare leg? Did he have one back in the? He had a spare one. Yep. Okay.
Yo.
Yes, he was out here getting it.
And that happened in D.C. That's in our backyard.
That's in your backyard.
Look out the window. You gotta watch your back. You gotta watch your back from everybody. Nobody is exempt.
No.
Y'all keep sleeping. Let me not even go there.
Keep sleeping, you gonna lose your leg.
What?
Keep sleeping, you gonna lose your leg.
Let me not even go there. Shout out to Amanda Wiles for that dope
Amanda
and great
Wiles,
story.
Thank you for crazy stories.
Yes. Man, that's crazy.
It's always crazy, y'all.
That's crazy. Like,
y'all.
My mind is still trying to process. Like, he is a mastermind.
I think he just lucked up.
You think so?
He just
lucked
up.
That's not luck.
That's what it is.
That's not luck.
Not enough.
Rest
somebody's
in peace to whoever he
lost.
Yeah. Rest
but
in
lucky
peace.
He's in jail. Yeah.
Craziness.
Give him 40 years.
But that's
Don't
crazy.
Book.
Give him Don't life. Me.
Give him life.
With no prosthetics. Just have no him in there all
no
natural.
Life. Take the other leg.
All natural.
And he won't be walking nowhere.
Oh,
man. Right? So I was watching an interview.
With?
On Vlad TV. With Bow Wow.
Bow-weezy.
I'm not too big of a fan of Bow Wow.
Let me tell you.
But, oh my gosh, you're going to tell me your fan
my
story.
My memory when Bow Wow came out with Bounce With Me, Bounce With Me. It's the beat to the O-Dub. But you wild even your girl. I mean, oh, I will always love Bow Wow for
lean
that.
Lean back now.
For
lean
that.
Back.
When he had that Mickey Mouse chain around his neck. And he ought to snatch up your daughters, but he's bought up for respect. But he done lost that respect. Go on with your story.
Somebody hurt over there, all right? You know, somebody hurt. Okay. So he finally talked on his relationship with Erica Mena of Love & Hip Hop. And, you know, when this relationship, I think everybody knew. Listen, to everybody knew that this relationship
wasn't
going to last. But his side of the story was that he had to choose between his daughter or his fiance.
No choice.
And the fact that him and his fiance and his baby mother didn't get along, you know, which probably happens a lot. They didn't get along. He was put up against the wall pretty much and had to decide whether he's going to spend more time with his daughter or, you know, he's going to have to spend more time
he
with his fiance.
He chose peace. It sounds like to me he just chose peace. Yeah, peace and sanity and sanctity. Can't nobody put a price on that. And no other person is worth that. And it's your child. So there's honestly no competition. There's honestly no choice.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
In my eyes, you have to make a choice. There's no choice.
But your does that come into play? What if your baby mama doesn't like any of your girlfriends that you bring?
Have to assess the situation. I think it was just her. I don't know if Erica Mena is the same as the personality she portrays on TV, but she's always fighting somewhere. And if that is her, I don't think she gets along with many people.
Well,
and mind you, I don't know her. I don't, but I'm just saying, like, if you just always...
Well, it was her relationship, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, I think he made the right choice. If those are the reasons why he made it, by all means, keep it moving. He still look good. She still look good. They going to find me.
Well, I just think that, you know, it's a hard situation to be able to be put in for any man to have to decide whether you're going to be with the girl that you, you know, proposed to and at the moment see yourself spending the rest of your life with versus you can't get along with my baby mother. So now it's affecting me and my time with my daughter. You know,
I don't know. I feel
situation.
Like when it's the right one, that kind of stuff will work itself out.
But even if it's the right one, I mean,
if they don't get along, they'll be able to be cordial. They'll be able to co-parent. It'll work itself out when it's the right one. I just don't think that was the right one. I think they both decided to go their separate ways.
Okay, so let's do a vice versa.
I mean, for you, if it was your child and it was a female that you were dealing with and the mother of your child didn't like that female and it was just getting really toxic, it was hard for you to spend enough time with your child.
Yeah, but let's say it's vice versa.
But
let's
what would
say,
you do? You did bypass my question.
I would. If it was me, I would have to try to balance it. I don't
and
know if I could.
And if you cannot balance it.
If I can't balance it, then you definitely have to do an evaluation.
And after the evaluation, what do you think?
I mean, it's just no brainer.
It's my kid.
I mean, it is no brainer, but at the same time, it's kind of like you don't want to get rid of that. You don't want to just drop that relationship just because.
But I'm sure he didn't drop it just because. I'm sure I would hope.
No,
he tried all that he could try.
Because
and
your baby mother, your baby
work.
Mother cannot like none of your women.
You don't know
any
that.
Any girl that comes around your baby mother, what you mean?
Some people get along. You don't know that.
That's just like if it was vice versa and I was a baby father, and pretty much I'm not gonna like any guy that you bring around.
Well, that's not good. That says something about you.
No, sometimes
it does. Sometimes like if you're over the like, relationship and it's all about your child, it should be an issue.
And you might not be and over
that,
the relationship.
That may be the reason. Because if somebody is a good influence in your child's life, now if they choosing sour and just choosing
I
horrible
be
people,
the only
there's a difference.
One.
Well, then that's your problem. That's your
you
problem.
You should stay with the girl
so
then,
stupid.
Right?
No.
You should stay with the girl.
Well, good for him. At the end of the day, your peace of mind. It's priceless. So he made the right decision for him. Point blank, period.
Well, I'm glad he finally talked about it. I'm glad he
I didn't really care.
No. They didn't talk about it. Well, you know, there wasn't no Will and Jada. But,
you know what I'm
saying? He was on the CSI. She was on her Love and Hip Hop. You know, she really had Love and Hip Hop, I guess. You know.
I wish him the best.
Good luck to
both of them.
Good luck to them. Hey, why not?
Yes.
So we are excited.
Special announcement.
Yes. I know y'all have been waiting and asking,
but I do appreciate you guys asking me, and I'm always happy to answer your questions, but we have it for you.
Yes. We have... our next Drinks and Conversation event.
Save the date.
So save the date. It is going to be, y'all ready? Because it's coming real soon. All right? It's going to be here real soon. So our next Drinks and Conversation tour is going to be September 3rd.
9-3.
Yes, indeedy. Yes, indeedy. We are making it happen.
It's going ham.
You heard it on episode 30.
Yes.
So
we 30 out here.
Yeah. So we get the problem.
I'm not even gonna say nothing. Like, you guys, this is gonna be the best one
this
yet.
This is gonna be the
it's
best.
It's gonna
one
be yet. Different. The conversation is still gonna be hot, but it's gonna be different. We're switching it up on y'all.
We're switching it up
on y'all, and we know you guys are gonna love it.
Listen.
I just can't wait to have y'all know we have a good night. So I can't wait to have a good night with you guys.
I cannot wait. It's Labor Day weekend. We are going to have a good time.
Because we ain't got no plans. We got plans to drink, conversate, kick it, and have a good time with y'all.
Let me tell you. And, you know, this time, I just feel like with this being the fourth installment, I feel like it's just... Oh my gosh! I'm just so I just can't.
Oh my gosh! It's going down.
It's going down. Like this one is going to be awesome.
Yes.
It's going to be awesome.
It's going down.
And we have our Instagram page up now.
We do. Drinks and Conversation.
Just search Drinks and Conversation on Instagram.
Yes.
And follow us. Everything will be in the more info box below.
Like our Facebook page.
And like our Facebook page.
Subscribe to us on YouTube.
Definitely subscribe. And I just can't wait for Drinks and Conversation 4. Y'all going to get more details as it comes.
Yes.
And we're going to fill you in with a lot more stuff. And you're going to probably be seeing some more of the advertisements and things going
on.
But you make sure you save that date. And
save
make sure
it.
You come.
Stamp
and hang
it.
Out with us. Intro tag pics. It. Oxytocin. Hey. So, you know, we about to get a problem. And listen, it's just been a blessing.
Yes,
that's it.
It is.
You know,
we want you guys to come out and have a good time. This one's going to be one for the book. So
this one's going
to
be for the book.
We're going to show you better than we can tell you. So wait on it.
Well, we about to get up out of here, y'all.
We got to go.
This is episode 30. I feel so grown. Because now we're going into the 30s.
Oh, gosh.
40s.
Cool.
And we got to have a celebration once we
oh,
get
you
like
know.
50.
You know we
and
party
100.
Well.
Yeah. We're going to get a popping. So we up out of here. It's Drinks and Conversation. Make
the
sure
podcast.
Y'all listen,
like,
and subscribe. Hey. We're going to lean back out of here.
Lean back. Walk around the metal detectors. That was my part. I was like, oh.
Everybody was like, hey.
We walk around. No, you need to go through. Put your keys in the bin.
She walked around the metal detectors, but she took everything out of the pocket of the purse before she went in. So, yeah.
Remy Ma.